Welcome back to Burn Peak. I'm Seth, and today we're gonna be doing something a little bit different, but kind of the same. Another episode of Cooking with Seth, but this time it's avocado toast. And I think you're gonna like it because it's easy, it's really tasty, and it's an energy-dense food that's good before you go out on a ride. So let's kick it off by making a piece of toast. This is sourdough bread that I got from a very bougie bakery. It's called Ingles Bakery. It's in my supermarket, and we're just gonna take this and stick it in the toaster. So while that's toasting, we'll mash up some avocado. If you've never cut open an avocado before, there's a big pit in the middle. So you cut down to the pit, turn it around. Once you open it up, you're gonna see that one side still has the pit on it. You can just take that old pit out because you don't wanna eat this. Unless you wanna eat this. You can use a spoon, you can use whatever your preferred method of getting the avocado out is. I cut it up into little cubes. And then squeeze it in there. You have a nice bowl filled with avocado. Just mash your avocado up a little bit. It doesn't have to be crazy. I like to leave it a little chunky. So now we're gonna take our toast. We're gonna put some avocado on it and just spread it around. And there you have it. That is the most basic version of avocado toast. If you can't make this, you better make a lot of money because you're gonna have to pay somebody to cook everything for you. This is about as easy as it gets. But it gets much better. Now, one thing that makes avocado toast a little bit better is seasoning. I prefer everything bagel seasoning. Everything bagel seasoning has salt, pepper, little pieces of dried garlic, sesame seeds, all sorts of garbage. So we take a nice hefty pinch of it and we spread it all over the avocado toast. And there we have some very basic and very tasty avocado toast. Okay, that was really good, but now I actually have to make dinner for my family. Got a dog, got a wife, got a little baby daughter, and they all want avocado toast, and so I'm gonna make it the way that all of them like their avocado toast. Because she's about to have a meltdown, I'm gonna have to make Rebecca her toast first. So I'm not gonna use the sourdough bread. The white bread's a little easier to chew for a 10-month-old. So for the baby toast, I'm gonna cut off the crust and I'm not gonna add anything to it, just toast and avocado. So we'll get that on there. And then I cut it into strips. Makes it a little easier for her. And now for a little garnish, we are gonna give her some banana slices. That is baby avocado toast and she is ready. Rebecca, is that your favorite? What's she gonna go for first? Oh, she went for the avocado toast first. Atta girl. Looks like Rebecca is enjoying her avocado toast. Now I'm gonna make my wife's, which is a little bit different because we're gonna add some eggs to it. Now, eggs taste amazing on avocado toast. I always have my avocado toast with eggs. If you've never made scrambled eggs before, just make any other type of eggs and then mess up. Scrambled eggs taste especially good if you don't overcook them. Probably took a total of 40 seconds to make these eggs. Okay, so for this very special avocado toast, we'll spread our avocado around. Then we're gonna stick a little bit of scrambled eggs on the top of it. May seem weird to mix eggs with avocado, but it's really not. I first had this at like a coffee shop I used to go to. Now we're gonna add everything bagel seasoning, tiny bit of salt, and hot sauce. And it's gonna make it much better, I promise. And so that is avocado toast for a full-fledged adult. There we go, mom has her toast. So now Oscar is about to have a nervous breakdown. I have to make him his avocado toast. Only problem is, you're not supposed to give avocados to dogs unless you want them to vomit. So we're gonna make Oscar's toast a little bit different. First of all, I'm not gonna bother toasting it because I'm sure he doesn't care. We're gonna make it exactly the way that we made Amy's toast, except we're not gonna put any avocado on it or hot sauce. And for presentation, we're just gonna add a little bit of dried parsley on Oscar's avocado toast. And that is a slice of avocado toast fit for a Frenchie. All right, Oscar. So now I finally get to make my avocado toast. So I think everybody likes a lot of avocado on their avocado toast, but I go hard in the paint. Whatever's left over, that's what's going on my toast. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Eggs. Got those scrambly, goopy eggs all over it. Little bit of the salt. Little bit of everything bagel seasoning. Little bit of parsley on the eggs. So this is my favorite habanero sauce. It's not super duper spicy, just got really good flavor. We are not gonna be bashful with it. Oh yeah. It's just so good. It's just so, so good. It's unbelievable how good it is. So good, it makes you want to saw. So that's how to make avocado toast. Really easy. It's one of the best tasting things in the world. And tell me in the comments what you like to put on your avocado toast. If you've never had it before, I hope you'll try it. And thanks for riding with me today. I'll see you next time. Say hello, toast. Look. Hi, toast.
Hey, say hi to the toast.
Hi, toast.
Hi, toast.